Hello everyone, today I'm going to show you about hemolytic uremic syndrome imaging. Terminology. Typical hemolytic uremic syndrome is a condition of thrombolytic microangiopathy occurring after diarrheal illness, hemorrhagic colitis from Zika toxin-producing bacteria. Classically, history here with 157 age 7. Clinical trial of hemolytic anemia and acute renal failure. Affected organ system, kidney, CNS. 20 to 50% of the gastrointestinal tract, heart and lung. A typical hemolytic uremic syndrome due to dysregulation in alternative complement pathway. Diarrhea is less common, higher mortality. Most common sign symptom: severe diarrhea plus minus bloody 3 to 5 days after inoculation. We see the renal failure by 2 to 4. The onset of hemolytic uremic syndrome: fatigue, pallor, decreased urine, body extremity edema, bruising, hypertension. Other sign symptoms: seizure, other mental status, visual disturbance. Less common: bowel necrosis, cardiovascular injury, pancreatitis, pulmonary hemorrhage. Demography: most patients are 3 to 5 years of age. Epidemiology: 1 over 100,000 children with TB. Classically associated with consumption of undercooked hamburger meat. Imaging bowel, platelet loop with wall thickening. Kidney, increased renal cortical echogenicity, decreased vascular perfusion of parenchyma, early with high resistant arterial flow, perfusion improved in second weeks. Improved diastolic flow precedes urine production. Brain potentially reversible, frequently symmetric lesion, restrictive shoes and tissue. Flare MR. Signal abnormality, deep gray nucleus, deep white matter, more than cortex core. Foci of T1 MR shortening due to hemorrhage necrosis. This is Doppler ultrasound in 15 months old with vomiting and decreased urine output, so an echogenic right kidney with completely reversed diastolic flow in the main renal artery. The left main renal artery shows similar finding. This is color Doppler ultrasound in same patient with hemolytic uremic syndrome. The 9 day letters of improved flow in the right renal parenchyma with return of diastolic flow in the main renal artery. The patient began producing urine the following day. Contrast intensity in the 3 day old with fever and bloody diarrhea. So diffuse marked colonic wall thickening with a region of hyper and hypo enhancement. There is marked surrounding inflammatory chain. Axial T2 player ADC map and SWI have high image in the same patient after a seizure show 4C of micro hemorrhage and restrictive use in pontamen and globus pallidus, a pattern consistent with hemolytic uremic syndrome surrounding the main extent to the insula. Contrasting NCT in the collar with vomiting and other mental status show globally decreased enhancement of the bilateral kidney through capsule enhancement remain intact. The main renal vein and artery appear patent. Color the blood of right kidney in same patient show turbulent flow in the main renal artery. The main renal vein is patent, even though vascular flow is seen in the renal parenchyma. And the renal cortex is mainly echogenic bilaterally. Subsequent spectral flushing demonstrated high resistant arterial waveform of the bilateral renal artery with reversal of distal diastolic flow. Treatment: typical support therapy, OVC transfusion plus minus plasma exchange, no direct treatment. Early fluid and antibiotic administration may lessen renal and neurological sequelae. A typical S about plus C5 antibody, Sumab for terminal complement blockade. Thank you.